Hi, in this demonstration, we will show how to include raster data in the Skyline's 3D digital globe. In this case, my base data is 5 km imagery with no elevation data included. To give the scene better definition, I will now add a low-resolution TIFF image from my local file system. I'm going to select Create Resolution Pyramid from the Tools menu to make the multiple levels of resolution needed to display the source efficiently at all distances. Note the file is now visible at all distances. To enhance the scene, let's add a data source from an urban area at a much better resolution. And now I'm going to add another image located adjacent to the first. Terra Explorer will automatically detect the file type, but for this demonstration, we'll use the files of type to show other supported formats. Sometimes you may need to enter a new projection, which is not included on the Select menu. In these cases, projection information can be entered into the well-known text box, as I'll show. Unfortunately, reprojecting the data lat long has created black rectangles around each source. In order to remove these from the first source, I will add a clip polygon, which will mask out these black areas. Terra Explorer Pro allows me to add a complex clip polygon to a raster layer right inside the program, or I can import a pre-made shapefile to act as the clip. As I'll demonstrate on the second image, you can use the Remove Null Values function inside the property sheet to remove a specific color from a raster automatically. When using elevation files, you can also remove a specific elevation value from the source. Showing the two sources side by side, you can see a gap in the higher resolution data. This will be overcome in a moment by importing an imagery file with a larger footprint. Now that we have several image rasters in the scene, I will add some elevation data. You can now see that the terrain changes. You'll notice specifically the elevation difference in the mountains. As I inspect the new elevation data, I come back to the scene in my high-resolution imagery. I previously used our application Terra Builder to tile several images into an easy-to-manage reference file called a TLT. Bringing this TLT into Terra Explorer Pro as an imagery file closes the gap. To add more imagery to the scene on top of these local imagery and elevation files, we can also add data from a Terragate or from WMS sources. You'll notice how the foreground and background are now consistent. This layer imports the content's selected Direct Connect project as a data source. Seeing that the Skyline Globe layer has now drawn on top of the TLT I brought in first, I need to adjust the draw order of the TLT using its property sheet. This feature is useful in handling many overlays at once. You'll note the difference of color balances for each source when seen up close. I can also load raster data by WMS. My previously connected WMS servers are already stored in the server address dropdown. In order to establish a connection and begin pulling data, I must select a lat long units per pixel value. The data will stream up to and including only that designated lat long UPP resolution as I zoom in. In this video, we began with a simple base MPT and loaded rasters to enhance the scene, including local imagery and elevation data. Then we enhanced the scene further with clip layers and layers added from Terragate and WMS.